Hi, I'm Ram Gopal from presentationprocess.com. In this video, you will learn a beautiful PowerPoint morph text animation trick. The beautiful trick you will learn to create today looks like this. As you can see here, we are going to talk about six different countries and the details, and this is the first slide. And once I finish explaining the details about the first country, then I click and I bring in the second country. And I explain, and then I bring in the third country. Note that there is color consistency between the font here and also of the text placeholder here. Notice also that these elements are changing. As I click again, you can see that the next country is brought in and the details are given. Another thing that I want you to note is you can see that this one is black in color. As it comes, you can see that the color changes. Here we have another country introduced, and finally we introduce the last country. Now the best thing about this is you can use it as a template and use it for a number of situations. Do you want to talk about the sales performance in six different regions of your company? You can use this. Do you want to talk about six different products you have on offer? You can use this as a template. Can you see it has a ton of practical use, and this template is very easy to create using PowerPoint morph transition. So let us learn how to create that morph transition from scratch. The first thing is to know how to write circular text. Now this is text that I've written just using the text box tool from AutoShapes Gallery. Now I'm going to go to shape format after selecting this, and then I'm going to use text effects, and then I'm going to go to ABC transform, and here I see the option called follow path, and it should be a circle. Now the next thing I need to do is to see what is the width of this shape here. You can see that the width is 8.25. Now if I want to have this as a circle, I need to have the height match the width, so I'm going to have this as 8.25 as well, and this is how it turns out. Now I can increase the font size, so let me go to Home tab and then select everything by pressing Ctrl A, and then I'm going to increase the font size like so. Now if you want to put some gap between the various countries, you just need to go here and then hit Tab, and if you want some more space you can hit the Tab again. So we have two tabs distance between this and this, and continue doing that for the other ones as well. So go here, hit Tab twice, and then go here, hit Tab twice. Now you can almost see that there is not enough space available in the slide area, so I'm going to zoom out. You can go here and click on the zoom out area so you can actually see it far clearer. Then I'm going to go here and then hit Tab a couple of times. Now as you can see here, there still needs to be a little more space covered. So I can do that by selecting all the text, and I can increase the font size a bit more, and then I can play with the space a bit more using backspace, tab, etc. All that is required for you to do is to find a way so that there is equal space between the various countries. Naturally, this is going to take a little bit of experimentation. Now you've got a proper circular shape available here. Now the next thing we need to do is to make sure that the text is clearly visible. For that, I'm going to use one of the shapes in AutoShapes Gallery called the donut shape. Let me go to basic shapes, and I'm going to use this donut tool, otherwise called as circle hollow. I'm going to hold the shift button down as I draw the shape over the earlier one, and I'm going to right click and send this to back. Now you can select the donut shape and also the circular text, then go to home, go to arrange and say align and align center, then go to arrange, align and say align middle. Now you can see that this is a perfect size. Now I'm going to make this hole slightly bigger for the donut, so I'm going to select just the outer shape, and then I'm going to use this yellow handle to increase the size of the hole in the middle. Now that looks good. Now if I want to make this look a little more interesting, let me go to shape outline and say no outline. Then I'm going to go to shape fill, go to gradient, and I'm going to choose the option here called as from center. And then let me change the color slightly. So let me go to format shape. Now here I have the second stop, which is blue in color. I want to choose white color for that one. And then for the outer one, I'm going to choose somewhere like this darkish color. And then for this one, I'm going to choose an even darker color, like so. And then I'm going to move these elements slightly inside like this. And then I'm going to move this from left hand side. You need to keep playing with the different options till the time you get a 3D kind of a look for this one. Now this looks perfectly fine. Once you're happy with this, you select everything, press Ctrl G, and we are going to place this somewhere over here. And then we are going to play with the option here called as size and properties, and we are going to do the rotation. So I am going to rotate in such a way that the first country is shown here, like India. And then you can write your title, and then you can write your subpoints. The way that I have done that is I have used a text box tool to write my title, and this is another text box tool where I have used bullet points. And then I used a simple rectangular shape, and then I cut it from the corner to give it some kind of a character. These are some two other shapes, and all this is completely in your hands. Whatever way you want to embellish your text placeholder, you can do. I'm just going to copy all these elements. I don't really want to waste your time showing you the different ways in which you can embellish your text here. So I'm going to press Ctrl V, and I'm going to place this, and then I'm going to right click and send this to back, and I'm going to have this say as India. And to make sure that the font color of India is the same color as this one, I'm going to go to the font color. I'm going to choose this color, that is the one that I used earlier, and I'm going to make the changes to all these things. Now we've got our first slide in place. Now the next thing I need to do is to go to thumbnails, and then I'm going to duplicate this slide by right clicking and going to duplicate slide option. And the next thing I'm going to do is to select this, and then right click, go to size and position. So we have the rotation option available here, and I'm going to rotate it so that I bring in the next country in focus. In this case, it happens to be Indonesia. And then I'm going to make changes to this one. So maybe the orange color, and then here darker orange color. And for this one, maybe a lighter hue of orange color. And then I need to make changes here as Indonesia. I am expecting that you will make all those changes. And you can also change the font color for Indonesia. Let me go here and choose orange color. Now I'm going to choose transitions, and I'm going to go to morph transition. And then we have got the effect in place. So this is our first slide. And then on a click, we bring in the next country, and then we make the details about that particular country. And if you keep repeating the process by having as many copies of this as the number of countries that you have in the circle, you would be able to create a really beautiful template which you can use multiple times for any number of reasons. Once you learn how to create this, then you can come up with your own variations. Yesterday, I showed you how to create this beautiful 5-part circular process graphic using PowerPoint. If you have not watched that video, you can do so by clicking on the I button here, which will take you to that particular video. Now, you can apply morph transition to this graphic like the way that you had applied morph transition to circular text example that we had just discussed. Let me show you that very quickly. I'm going to select everything, and I'm going to press Ctrl G. Now, the first thing I need to make sure is that this thing is a proper square. Otherwise, the circle will not really rotate the way that you want. So let me go to Shape Format, and you can see that there is a slight bit of discrepancy between the height and the width. Now, you can't really stretch any of these elements here. Otherwise, that will distort this particular shape. So the best bet that we have is to create a ghost shape behind this. So let us go to Auto Shapes Gallery, pick up a circle. Then I'm going to hold the Shift button down as I create a beautiful circle. Then I'm going to right click and send this to back. And then I'm going to take this shape here. Then let us go to Home, go to Arrange, Align, and say Align Center, Arrange, Align, and Align Middle. And then I'm going to group this together. Now you can see that when you go to shape format, the height and width is exactly the same. Now since this is a ghost shape, let me go to shape outline and say no outline, shape fill and say no fill. Now when we have this in place, you can always rotate this the way you want by right clicking and going to size and position option. And let me rotate it in such a way that the first position is like this, and I'm going to keep it over here, and I can add some kind of a symbol here. Maybe I can use this circle, and I can give this the same color as the one that I see here, the dark hue, and I'm going to go to shape outline and say no outline, and I'm going to add another shape on top of it to hold the text. So I'm going to use this rounded rectangle shape, and I'm going to move the yellow handles to the center so that the shape looks like this, and then I'm going to give this a lighter green color like this, and then shape outline, no outline. And to add a bit of drama, go to shape effects, go to shadow and use inner shadow, and then you can write your text here. I'm going to select all this and I'm going to press Ctrl G to group this. Then let me duplicate this, right click, duplicate slide, and then here I'm going to rotate this. So let us go to size and position and then rotate this so that we are able to get the next color in place, which happens to be this yellow color. Make some adjustments and then choose this circle to be of the darkest hue and then this one of slightly lighter hue, and you can write your text here. And for the duplicate, go to transitions and apply morph transition. And when I go to this one, go to slideshow, you can see that the color changes as the wheel position changes. Can you see the principle is just the same? The underlying graphics are different and the effects are different. The reason why I'm able to come up with so many creative ideas is I understand the various tools in PowerPoint thoroughly, and I also understand the various applications of the tools. If you too want to have such a thorough understanding of PowerPoint and be creative with your use of PowerPoint slides, then I highly recommend that you join our Ram Gopal's PowerPoint Mastery Program. This program is arguably the most comprehensive and creative PowerPoint training program online. I will leave a link to this product in the description box below the video. You can click on the link and come to this page and check out all the details about this program. By the way, did you like our PowerPoint morph text animation trick? If you did, then please give this video a thumbs up and share it with your friends. If you want to watch more such videos that offer creative ideas in using PowerPoint and Excel, then please consider subscribing to this channel and also hit the bell notification so that you will be notified whenever we post new videos in this channel. Thanks a lot for watching this video. I'll see you in the next one.